146 green.
This is moon base to shadow control. Predicted trajectory termination, North Atlantic. Speed, solid.
Going for intercept, out.
Down, right, left.
Alright, I'm gonna chuck this sucker. Huh? Whoa.
What made it turn?
I don't know. I don't know. Maybe the way I threw it.
Because it was coming to me real hard. You know, I wanted to launch it, but it was like it was going to immediately turn.
Mm-hmm.
Let me see what it
feels. Well, that one's a little loose, but that's okay.
Now, will it change your center of gravity if you... take these off since you're not
what?
Going.
Nah. What nah. Well, I want to. For now, I want to keep them on.
Okay.
Yeah, the whole CG is.
Is based off with
yeah.
these on. Okay.
All right, let's give it another shot and then we'll. Yeah. One thing is, so you just kind of like this, like just run like you're holding a torch, and then you just kind of let it do what it's got to do. If it's gonna fly, it's gonna fly. If it's gonna stall, it's gonna stall.
All right. So you know, just as soon as I get to the grass. I'll get the speed and launch it.
Watch your feet now. I don't want you messing up your feet. So you're gonna when you hear me go to full power and I'm at full, then you go ahead and alright, here we go. I'm at full power. Whoa. That is nutty. Yeah.
Right there. And right there.
Okay. What was that?
I said that definitely seemed like something might be strutting.
Yeah, I'm definitely getting a torporal.
No damage done, but that was a torporal.
All right, let's try and repair it again.
Okay.
It's tough.
This is a tough ass bird. God almighty.
You carry him and grab the sheet.
Okay.
And it rolled.
See, think if you kind of give it a little more ailerons, take care of some of that torque, or?
She's got a lot of deflection at the moment. My fear is putting too much aileron in and then that will create a roll all its own.
Oh, okay.
You know, the old saying, overkill.
Yeah. I just realized you're using, what they call them? Elevons?
Yep.
It's your elevator and your ailerons is all in one.
Mm-hmm.
Let's get off. A little crack right here. I don't know if you just want to put a little bit on the outside right here on this side. You see what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Just a little crack right there if you can get a little bit.
Yeah, you got that right. I'm going to have to I'll just put a piece of tape on that sucker.
Yeah, there you go.
That should hold it.
Good old tape.
Good old tape. This is half-ass field repair, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, that's where I mean. That you got to go through to get it right.
And ladies and gentlemen at home, this is why I built two of these things, because one's already destined for the shop, and this one is on its way. This one is definitely on its way. All right, up down. Ah, son of a bitch, man. I'm telling you, it's killing me.
Off of that, you know, too, but... Because it's lighter, way lighter than what I thought it was. Because I hadn't even picked up the whole jet until I picked it out. I was like, man, ain't no weight on that. And that's when I got it from Brad. And I was like, okay, so it is actually light.
I'm taking a page out of your playbook. Taking a little bit of your advice. I think some of the roll has to do with these. I'm taking the fuel tanks off.
Oh, yeah?
Yep. I'll bet you any amount of money is these damn fuel tanks. They're messing up the airflow under the wings. I'll bet you any amount of money. Now it's a little bit more like a Habu. A half-ass Habu. Very half-assed Habu. You up for one more hand launch?
Oh, yeah.
All right. This is the last one, I promise. After that, we're done. I really don't want to do any. I don't want to tempt fate.
Anytime.
Clean up the... Clean that up a little bit. Like Vance said, hey, why don't you just take these things off? And I'm like, you know what?
It ain't hurting it.
I think the both of you have said that already. You're like, hey, man.
We're not using the wheel, so.
Yeah, so this is definitely, yeah.
You'll
this
get
is,
another look.
Let me just CG it. Well,
That's what I was looking at. How do you determine the CG on here?
It ain't easy. It ain't easy. Just from basic, kind of, you know, just get a little bit of guesswork, a little bit of calculation, a little bit of guesswork. Okay, we don't need the. All right, we need the rudder. Need that.
Definitely. A minute ago, you could tell the CG wasn't bad at all.
Right.
It maintained the angle that I launched it. It's just it was
that torque. Yeah.
This plane is gonna fly today. I don't give up. Monkey's ass. This thing is flying today.
Make sure there's nothing else showing anywhere.
My only fear is I'm going to put this on and I'm going to try something. This is a CG trick. You just... All right, yeah, it's going to be nose heavy. I'm going to have to take the landing gear out. This is in the field messing around right now, baby. We're not in the workshop now. We're just down and dirty. What I got to make sure is I don't mess.
This is the way you tested it.
I don't mess the plane up too bad.
Together, right.
This is the one, the landing you messed up on first time, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
This is all the stuff that's got to go back to the shop. And I'm telling you, I'm probably going to have an upset stomach tonight.
Well, that's all about.
But this is how you get your data.
You got that right. Let's hope she gets airborne. This in. If it does what it's doing now with this new configuration, then we definitely have got, we got something. We know that there's something else wrong,
right?
That's not, you know.
I mean, everything just looks so centered, so perfect, so.
You would think. You would think,
it's
but.
It's just screaming, I want to fly.
Mm-hmm. Let me see how I got the CG now. It's a little bit better. She's a little nose heavy. She's definitely gonna want to dive. I'm gonna have to move that back a little bit. So did you eat, Brad? Did you get a little?
Okay.
That was fast. I swear
to you.
You left and then you came right back.
I'm just right down the road.
Vance is pretty close, but I mean, you're right around the corner.
Way closer than me.
Yeah.
If you think I'm close, Brad,
yeah,
you
he's
almost throw a rock. Fly or fly a plane.
Fly a plane
house,
over there and pick lunch up and bring it back.
I'm telling you. If he had a quadcopter with FPV on it,
he'd
say, honey, quad over there.
Drop me a sandwich.
Drop me a sandwich.
I like that. It should fly on its own thrust.
It's gonna do something different.
Yeah, it's going I like that. I like that point of view.
Do something different.
There you go, boss.
It's gonna do something different. Oh, show.
Well, I'm telling you, you're getting your practice now. You're gonna be a pro hand launcher before we're done.
Oh, I can tell. I got a new CG.
Oh, you can feel that?
Yeah, a little bit. Just a little bit.
This is gonna be hairy, but hey. We're just having fun. All right, so I'm going to go to full power.
Give me just a second.
Yeah, you get ready. Hang on for 1 second here.
All right, I feel pretty good.
You feel good? All right, that's good. All right, here we go. I'm going to go to full power. Whoa!
Oh, boss, you were pretty there for
that. Ah! She almost had it, but she's rolling. She's spinning.
This one talked to the left.
Yeah. What do you think? She's good for one more try? What do you think?
Ain't too bad.
Could, you think you could add a little trim on
yeah.
the aileron?
Ladies and gentlemen, this is one tough bird.
That sucker. Yeah, I mean, it's good.
Let's try it. Let's try it one more time. Let me just make sure let me give her a once over. This has got to be the toughest goddamn airplane I've ever built. This
that
is,
was a nice loss.
The nose is a little, the
yeah,
nose is a little
not
crumpled.
Bad.
But
made like a shark now.
Yeah.
There's enough of them biting.
I ain't lying. We're going to turn it on. We'll blow it out the back in case there's anything.
Yeah. All right. Let me just.
Think if you give it a little elevator, I mean an aileron trim.
It torqued to the left. This one did.
Left.
Yeah.
All right. All right. Let me give it a little bit. All right. Hang on. Torque to the.
Torque
to the left. Torque to the left. So I'm gonna have to give her a little bit of right. Hang on, let me check her out.
All right. It wasn't bad. I mean, it didn't torque like the other one.
No, it had a good straight flight for a minute.
Yeah.
Hang on here. All right, she torqued to the left. Wait a minute. All right, here we go. Well, you know what? I want you to get a little bit longer. Takeoff run,
okay,
and then from like right here, and then go on an angle.
Okay, a little then, longer. Little
yeah,
longer
a little
jog.
Bit, a little bit longer jog, and then let you know.
All right,
here we go. Whoa, you almost had that! You almost had that.
Long run just wasn't gonna do it.
I hope the guy that created this model, David Meddings, isn't watching that. He's probably laughing his ass off right now.
That's all that happened right there.
Okay.
Just a little...
That's not too bad.
Good Lord, man. What'd you build this thing out of?
I mean, that's it.
I mean, that's torque spin or something. I don't know. I know for a fact that
that
I'm not
a bad launch though.
Well,
too much running in
I gotta redo that rudder real fast. Yeah, I gotta just hit that with some CA and then we'll try one more time.
Yeah, just if I run too long, I get off balance.
Oh, no problem.
I am 47 years old.
What? 46? I didn't take you a year over 40. What are you talking about? I'm 40. I'm 40. You don't look 47.
Do a little better running.
Well, I'll tell you, something's keeping you young.
Oh, it launched straight up. That might be the CG to the back doing that too. Was it nose heavy or?
She is just.
It seemed like I took it straight up. I'm trying to give you more, you know, a little bit like that, but it didn't look like that. Yeah.
She's just rolling. There's something going on here that I'm not. Something's happening. It could be the dihedral of the wing. It could be.
That first run, it was like this for a good bit before it rolled.
Yeah.
On the first flight, it was actually straight there for a good 3 seconds.
Let me look at your elevator.
This one should have went up some. It looks like that one went up. That's why I would have rolled more this time to the left.
Let me go to sub-trim.
What that looked like to you, Brad?
Let me see.
When the left aileron is up, that would have put pressure on that.
Kick it.
To the left.
To the,
right, so this one needed to come
if
up.
If this is up, it's going to roll to the right. It's going to prevent rolling to the left if this one is up.
That one's going
to? It's going to prevent roll to the left if that one's up.
Right? Aim backwards. Because as your left aileron goes up,
then you're going to turn to the right.
No,
that's right.
Yeah.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're right. I'm sorry.
It needs to come up some.
If it's, yeah.
Okay,
you're right.
Yeah. So that one, all right, hang on here. Let me get in the sub
trim. To counteract the torque.
Y'all, my second day out here, I had something happen. Oh, I rebound. Second time I ever flew. He was here the first time I ever flew. And it was on that plane, second flight I ever had. I came out here, was all excited, ready to fly. I take off and I hit the elevator to pull back and it nosedives. You'd have thought I'd have checked everything at that point, right? I switched them up and I said, all right, now I'm ready.
Another thing that's not helping us, we got no wind.
No.
We got zero wind.
Looking at the sop, it's just a little of something, but.
Yeah. You let me know when you're ready, buddy.
Okay.
All right, we ready? All right. Whoa!
That was better.
You're right. She's rolling though. She's just rolling.
Still rolling too. It's the torque.
Yeah. Any damage?
I think this is made out of 1/4-inch steel.
Yeah, just about.
And it stayed down for a good
while. It stayed upside down.
Right.
No?
Dang, God, how'd you make that out of that?
Hang on.
This thing's tough.
I meant the rudder's off there. That's a problem right there. The rudder is
jammed up right now.
No, I'm trying to get it.
Oh, you insulted. Yeah.
This thing is a freaking tank. All right, let's giddy up. Let's try one more time.
That was up there, man.
I mean, was the best one. No problem.
Yeah. I tell you, we're getting a lot of flight time with all these little flights. I could edit together one big flight.
One big with two.
See Brad running like five times.
Oh, that was good though. Same thing.
What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go to full power, then go. All right, you ready? Damn,
okay.
She is just rolling.
Give it a little more on the right.
A little more on the right?
A little bit more.
What I think is going on here is there's something aerodynamically happening that's just killing us.
I think I just saw it. We've got a shift in our engine.
Oh, yeah. The duct. The duct
is.
Definitely. I think she's finally. Oh, it's just the air duct.
It's just the air duct?
Yeah.
The engine hasn't shifted.
Nah. It's just the air duct.
I don't understand what it, it's staying straight, isn't it?
Yeah.
And then when it starts to get that altitude, it wants to roll which way? Because I'm not watching.
To the left.
It's rolling. This one's still rolling to the left.
Okay.
All but right. The funny thing about this one now is when it rolls to the left, it almost wants to stay.
It almost wants to stay there.
Yeah.
Yep.
All right. Well, there's our turn right there. So we'll try one more time.
What you got? What'd you put in it just then?
I just gave a little bit more.
Right aileron?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What is that noise?
I'm wondering, why do we have so much lift here,
yeah,
but not as much here? Is that making a difference, or is that a optical illusion?
This bulb here, this bulb might be doing something. This thing was never made to fly. This thing,
exactly.
This freaking thing was never designed to fly. It was just designed. It was a model.
Yeah, it was a model.
Model on a ship. It was a front. You know, this is a submarine jet. This comes out of the ocean.
Okay, yeah, I remember that. Okay. I remember seeing that. Now.
Yeah, this was UFO. This
sure
thing
was.
Comes up out of the ocean.
What?
So we'll try one more time, and then, so if she's rolling. We got it dealt with now.
We'll try it here, back at the camera.
I got the camera right here. Okay. Yeah, you're here. Are you more comfortable on the grass?
Either way.
Okay, yep. I'm gonna go to full power. All right, well, that's the end of that.
That wasn't smooth.
Yeah, that was rough.
The other three were okay. That launch didn't make it.
Yeah.
And that may have got us there.
Yeah, well. I think it's back to the drawing board. Any more, we're just going to be totally destroyed. Yeah, we're just going to start.
We're going to lose the flight.
Yeah, we're going to completely destroy it.
So something with the roll and it staying there should tell you something. Because, man, it was like it wanted to stay right there.
It
wanted to stay inverted.
Yeah. Hey, I just want to thank Brad and Vance, my two buddies at the flight field. You two made the difference, man. Brad being my launch man. And Vance, with his experience and knowledge of RC, giving me the idea about the elevons and, you know, rolling to the left and adding a little bit of right elevon to help out. And I'm telling you, it made all the difference. It helped. And I'm grateful. And remember what I told you guys in my Joel Null video about the people in this hobby that make the hobby great. And these two good friends of mine are being out there. Made all the difference. So thanks, guys. Thank you. I'm grateful. Hey, all right. Demon Driver here. I'm back home. It is night, obviously. And here are my two Sky 1s. Sky 1 Gabrielle Drake and Sky 1 Wanda Ventham. The beautiful two British actresses in UFO. Two beautiful British birds. And as you can see, they're fine. Sky 1 Wanda has got a little damage in her nose. It's not that big of a deal. I'll simply either chop that off and redo it with a new foam sanded styrofoam nose. Just fit that on, tape it down, paint it, no big deal. Driver here. Okay, after reviewing and watching the videos, one of the main reasons I take all these different videos is to, when things go wrong, I can play them back and take a look to see what went wrong, what happened. So what I mainly see is a lot of instability with the Sky 1 design. You got to remember something. In 1970, the Sky 1 was thought up by master British model maker David Meddings, right? So David Meddings and the model makers of 21st century productions, the guys that worked with Gerry Anderson, in 1970-71, they had to come up with different models and different things for Shado for their aircraft and vehicles, you know, the moon base interceptor. And these guys were like, you know what, let's come up with something, some kind of submarine, and there's a fighter jet in the front, and the thing comes up and the fighter jet flies off and boom, and the kids go yay, and the thing, and you got Skydiver, and it's going around. When they cooked up these things, they never thought about making an actual flying aerodynamic aircraft, because if they had, it wouldn't look like this at all. But I, thinking that I could take what I know about aerodynamics and make, if I made it light enough and gave it an airfoil and gave it a tail, made it like it is, it'll fly. Not quite. There's a gent
a gentleman in the United Kingdom goes by the name of RC Nutt. Now, he claims to have built a Chuck Glider version of this. And he's like, you know, yeah, I built the Chuck Glider, it flew fine, and it did, you know. That's possible. Maybe he did. I don't know. He claims that he did. That's fine. If he did, so be it. More power to you. But this is powered. It has an EDF inside, and it has weight to it. It has actual, it's not just a Chuck Glider. And what I found is I made a couple of mistakes. I have my weight of my battery and ESC up high. I have my ESC mounted to the upper top wall above the air duct. So I have a lot of weight up top, so it's making it, weight-wise, it makes it want to roll and the weight wants to go to the bottom. That's the first thing I noticed. Second big problem is take a look at the profile. I have anhedral in wings, that's scale. Okay, for Sky-1, it has anhedral. Anhedral is the negative of dihedral. Dihedral is like this. Anhedral is what you see. It's a downward. And that is designed to create stability in flight. Dihedral or anhedral helps create stability. Now, in this case, it doesn't. It does the opposite, I think. So that's the second thing. First thing is I have to move the weight of the ESCs and batteries to the lower portion below the air intake. That's the first thing. Second thing is get rid of the anhedral and have a straight horizontal wing. It has no anhedral. Third improvement that must be made is the wing itself. I'm going to enlarge the wingspan by about 25% and possibly move the wing cord up a bit, actually give it probably, in all, maybe a 30 to 40% increase in the wingspan. That's gonna make life a lot easier. So, by doing these things, weight of battery, ESC, shift it down, get rid of the anhedral, increase wingspan, and maybe even re-evaluate the CG. I have the CG right here. For those of you, you might think that that's a little bit too forward. I did my calculations and this came like right in the strike zone, right in here for the CG. Now maybe I need to move it back a little bit. That's possible. But this is not all based to CG. There's a lot of things going on here. And again, this is something that was never designed to fly. It was designed to hang off strings in a Pinewood Studios soundstage in the United Kingdom and fly out on rails out of the water, and you know, a film crew would film it and then they would edit it and it would be in UFO. So that's what this is. So I'm trying to take it from that and turn it into a functioning fighter jet, a functioning Sky-1. It's not easy. It's not easy at all. It's hard. But the beauty of this and the challenge of this is the fact that I'm taking something and I go to the flight field and I find out what I need to find out to make this thing fly right. I'll never find out by sitting on my ass at home and criticizing other people who try this, like me. A lot of people, like, they go onto my videos and they attack me and they go, you know, man, you don't know what you're doing. You're just a big idiot. You're out there with your models. You're just an idiot, man. You just go around and all your planes crash and they all suck and you're just a big idiot, dude. You know, why you waste your time, man? Because it's fun. You live once. I mean, come on. I'm 40 years old and for a living, I make models. I like my life. I enjoy this. I wouldn't trade it for anything in the world. I'm not rich, but I'm happy. And you can do the same thing. You can be happy too. Just get out there and scratch build. You know, scratch build. Do something new. Do something different. Take something that's never flown before, a spaceship, a plane. Take a plane that's already flown. Scratch build your own version and put all your heart and effort into it. And if you're real smart, build two and go out there and have fun. It's the most fun you're ever going to have. And for those people that, you know, every once in a while, I don't, you know, you're always going to get haters, but for those people that always knock me and put me down, you know, and say all my planes crash. Not all my planes crash. Sometimes I might have a hard landing. I might have a, you know, a scrape up. But like the L-1011, I flew that plane at 60 miles an hour into a freaking tree, and it's inside being repaired, and it's going to fly again. Every plane that you've seen maybe have a bad landing on my videos, they're all fine and repaired, and they fly again. And again, and again, and again. And this is going to fly again. I'm going to make the corrections, I'm going to make it work, and I'm going to make it fly, because that's what I do. That's what I do. And I love doing it. And I love, and I'm honored by you guys watching, your views, your subscribership. I am honored. I'm grateful. I'm not an egomaniac. I'm not full of myself. I don't walk around like, you know, hey, you know, I'm the king of this. I'm nothing. I build planes and I have fun. And I film it so you guys can enjoy it and kind of come along with the journey and maybe learn a thing or two. That's what it's all about. So, you know, just be patient, because I'm telling you, like the Orion, never flown before. The 2001 Orion, that's never flown before. That was a model designed for a movie. I'm taking it and trying to turn it into an actually flying plane. It ain't easy. It's hard, but I'm going to make it work, and it's going to work. I promise. I got to make modifications, but I'll make it work. Same thing with Sky-1. I will make this work. And I've got tons of other spaceships and models and science fiction things coming on this channel. I got stuff inside there that will blow your mind. And it's coming. I got Japanese anime spaceships coming. Oh man, wait till you see what's coming.